So the process would be to strategize in which observations on user wants and needs and then are captured through various stakeholder interviews and business goals analysis and then competitive analysis. And we will build this persona, build and analyze these requirements. In other words, we will start with the business goals plus documenting of the user needs. Once this is done, we move on to the scope where we build these functional specification and then content requirements. And then we move on to the structure and skeleton where we formalize the information architecture, interface design, navigation design, information design, sketch and wireframes. And finally, we will move into the surfacing phase where we do the visual design and prototyping. And the result of this will give us the best in user interface experience. Having understood what is a digital experience layer, it is a good practice and it is recommended by oecloud that you will have to think in terms of the complete user experience and not just at a UI level. So in order to implement the digital experience layer with oecloud framework, we have three approaches. One is you can make altogether a new solution, in which case you are going to make use of the core API services in order to get the models done. And once the models are done, the relationships can be established, validations can be built into them. And then once we do that, we can take care of this data personalization, internationalization, aspects like label change and data source personalization. And as a result of this, we get the REST APIs and then Node APIs, and also we could build the cross DB capabilities. So these are the core setup services, but apart from this, there are many other options which are available, which come to us out of box using the core API services. Here, the thing to notice is that we mainly work with the aspects of configuration rather than deep coding and then coding at a deeper level in order to incorporate these features. Mere configurations will help us to get all these effects done with the model-driven approach that we are taking. And once we do that, as part of the new solution, we also can build the user interface development done. So having these models created, we could depend on a set of web components to create the UI screens. As part of that, we could be building themes, we could be building the web components basing on this for the styles, and also followed by the web components which are required in order to perform the various UI related functionalities. And it is possible to personalize the UI. For instance, the model could be containing a label with a value, and in the UI, if you want to represent a different label for a underlying field, it is possible to do so using the UI personalization. And also, whatever are the validations that are placed as part of the model definition, all will be part of the validation framework, and the UI screens will be built in such a way that these rules are enforced on. And one more great feature about this oecloud DEL layer is that you will be able to build lot of screens rapidly with the meta UI. So meta UI is a concept where it will borrow the model definition, and basing on that, it will generate the forms automatically, and it will internally make use of all the themes and then the CSS which are available as part of it. So when we get this done, the meta UI also enforces that all the validation rules are taking place properly. And in case you have additional validations, those things can also be built as part of the DEL layer requirements. And it is possible to configure routes in a very user-friendly manner. And of course, the app themes can be generated and then can be reused. And the responsive pages, in order to build, one could make use of this Cordova-based applications. So this is essentially how a new solution works. Now, there can be several situations where you have a base solution which is in place, which means that the API services are running and then the microservices are running, and already probably that enterprise would be making use of a application which is delivering these impacts. So, when you want to develop a new part of an application, it is not necessary that you touch the older solution. You could simply build a digital experience layer basing on the oecloud framework, which in turn talks to this API services, and all these can be configurable items. So you can be using a set of web components that talks to a existing API, and it will help you to deliver this functionalities to you. So therefore, you are only building the digital experience layer which is required for that base solution, which achieves that new set of goals for you. So this is how the OE Cloud essentially helps the implementation of DEL.